Stowe Mountain Resort has reopened for the ski season. Amid a pandemic, the experience is unlike any other before. Like all ski mountains owned and operated by Vail Resorts, there are new rules and protocols. Everyone must wear face coverings. Related parties can ride chairlifts and gondolas together, whereas singles are either placed alone or with one other person on the opposite side of the lift. To limit the number of skiers on the hill to allow for social distancing, guests are required to reserve their ski days online in advance. Those without prior reservations aren't able to access the lifts.
You have to plan ahead, but the system actually works very simply and very well. I was not a happy man when they announced it, but it works very, very simple.
You know, I was a little skeptical at first, but I have to say that the mountain is doing a great job with the reservation system. It's worked perfectly so far. The lift operators and the lift line operators are doing a super job making sure people have their masks on.
Initially, there were concerns about overcrowding. But now, the bigger concern among businesses at least is that there won't be enough people coming to ski.
Under normal circumstances, Stowe and many of the other Vermont ski resorts are a top weekend destination for people living in cities like Boston and New York. But this year, the governor is requiring all out-of-staters to quarantine for either 2 weeks or 1 week following a negative COVID test result, effectively making it an impossible destination for many.
A representative for Vail Resorts in Stowe said the mountain expected fewer skiers this year. Nevertheless, the priority remains to keep the mountain open without interruption.
We're definitely not focused on volume. We're focused on managing the number of guests that we can accommodate safely based on the number of lifts that are open, the amount of terrain that's open. And our goal is to really be able to provide that mountain experience for people all winter long.
As a publicly traded company, Vail Resorts has greater financial wherewithal to handle the economic effects of the crisis. It's tougher for many of the smaller nearby businesses that rely on visitors. The Stowe Area Association says hotel occupancy rates are projected to drop by up to 45% this winter as compared to last year.
We're hearing it all, and it's a really hard time, and really listening to what businesses are going through is part of what we're doing, is trying to be able to see how we can support them during this time.
Vermont provided $75 million in relief to the hospitality sector and another $2.5 million for ski resorts. The hope is that more aid will come to help businesses survive what is expected to be a tough winter. Karina Huber, CGTN, Stowe, Vermont.